is. Like the... You're screwing in light bulbs. Screwing them in. Screwing them in.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of... The Intellectuals.
Intellectuals.
I'm your host.
Mr.
Don. Poseidon.
Don Poseidon. Don yeah. Pardo.
And I've got my co-host over here. Guido Grasso.
Yes. Hello, everybody.
I don't know why I'm doing the British accent.
Happiest of New Year's to you, my friend. I'd like to wish you...
Yes, happy...
Happy 2021. Let's hope this year is almost as good as last
year. What was it, 5,000-something?
In the Jewish calendar.
I identify as Jewish right now.
Are you identifying
as Jewish? But
I didn't know Jewish was a sexuality.
But just right now. Just right now.
Right now you feel Jewish?
Just right now,
is that because you're wearing something that comes out of that... Hidden Gems movie with Adam Sandler.
No,
that's where your bracelet is. Your bracelet.
Got that bracelet. It came from Adam Sandler.
From that movie. Yeah, you look like you got that. That is that where that bracelet came from?
Yeah, Adam Sandler gave it to me himself.
Oh, we're gonna give you a bracelet. Give you a little bracelet.
Yo, so how you?
Little Nicky, how I've been? Good. It's yes, good. That's. Did you see the bullshit in my face when I said good?
Yeah.
I feel good.
Good, good. I feel good too. But yeah.
Right.
I don't know what to talk about because
you don't want to talk, man. You're just angry. Why are you
No, I'm not angry. I feel
Why does your shoulder
I feel trash.
You feel trash?
Yeah.
Whoa, that's
I feel
a big
like,
word.
I feel trash. Like trash, yeah.
You feel like trash.
Yeah.
What circumstances led you to feel that? Or is it physically?
No, inside. I feel like trash.
Your tattoo looks like the top of a New York City coffee cup. It's been a pleasure to serve you.
That's where I got it from.
You got it.
I looked at the coffee cup.
One
and
of
I was
those
like,
guys.
Shh, I'm always drinking coffee, bro.
There's a specific.
Fucking.
There's a specific word for that. What is that called?
The
that
Greek key. Oh no! In Greek, it's meandro.
Meandro.
I think it's. Is it that?
It's meandering. Does it mean the same thing?
No. Meandro.
Meandro.
In Greek.
So it sounds Italian. Meandro. This is meandro.
Or Italian sounds like Greek.
Italian.
I don't know. Somebody came first, bro. I don't know. I'm just saying.
You're an idiot.
Sophocles. As a guy, I come to a Yonkers and I opened Olympus Diner and it's good business. I used to sleep downstairs when we first come here. When you come back from Greece, why did you go? What did you have to eat while in Greece? Goat.
Well, goat is good.
That's what
goat have you tried goat cheese?
Yes, fromage de chèvre. It's what I put on the quattro formaggi. But no, literally, I was. New York has a lot of those, like here, like those Paul and Suzanne places. And there's one by Yonkers Racetrack. Where they have the horses like blue bonnets, and literally Olympus Diner, it's actually on like a mound, like in a parking lot. Imagine like I don't know what's where Dairy Queen is on La Chapelle or whatever, something like that. But it's actually elevated, and
Dairy
you go
Queen.
Up and you eat there at 3 a.m, 4 a.m. It's Greek diner. So we've spoken to the owner. And he literally said that when he first came over in the 70s, they would work in the diners and they would literally sleep downstairs.
Oh, shit. Yeah. That's rough.
Yeah. And then I asked, what did you have to eat in Greece? What was there? He goes, there was nothing. What was there? Goat. But he said it with such conviction.
Yeah.
Like he literally, that's all they literally had to eat.
Yeah. Tough times. Yeah. You know, my father has a theory that the Greeks were actually sold as slaves to North America. Under the guise,
it's because
of,
he used the word slave that makes it sound
far
fetched.
Yeah, under the guise of
but to use our grandparents and parents in this very building to work on sewing machines for almost nothing. Absolutely,
yeah,
that's a fact. And they were able to actually buy a house with the cash under the.
So is that really a slave? Bed. That's not really a slave then.
But he used that word to an extreme.
Yeah.
But the reason they brought us over, yes. Yes, Italy.
Yeah, they needed workers. Yeah,
nothing,
but that.
And
but
we
that
needed in the industry.
But that's why people open their doors to immigration.
That's how that's how neighborhoods were built. This
yeah,
neighborhood
yeah.
down there was built
course,
exactly
yeah, yeah.
for
people like my parents and uncle's generation.
Right no, but there. He literally means that...
He just used the word slave to the extreme.
No, no, no. He literally means...
To the extreme, I rock a mic like a van.
Not too. Just to the extreme, but literally means like...
Or extreme.
Greeks were literally... Words. The Greeks were literally bought, like paid for, like... Greeks, well, Italians, Irish. Well,
Greeks were bought and paid for.
I think he might be right.
Yeah, the government.
Oh shit! For real?
I know that in the '50s, when they were leaving, the Greek government was receiving money from North America for each citizen that they were sending over.
Oh shit! Oh shit! I didn't know that. Okay, so my father was right on this one.
No, he wasn't, because they were not slaves.
Oh, okay.
He used that word. I said he used that word. He used the extreme.
Okay,
word.
Okay, yeah.
But we're all slave to the rhythm, said Michael Jackson. Slave to the
rhythm. Your father's a master of half-truths, yeah. All lies.
we're all slaves.
Your father hang out in bars a lot, like Greek?
No, he hated
where everybody,
bars.
Everybody's
like Cliff that.
Clavin expert?
Yeah.
It's a lot of that?
They're all Cliff Clavin.
Everybody's an expert?
I don't know who that is, Cliff Clavin.
Check your ancestry.com. You might be related to him.
Why are you shaking?
Because I'm... a mess of a person and a human being.
You're really not. You're harder on yourself than you should be.
Yeah.
That's right.
You're harder on yourself than he is on himself, and he should be harder on himself.
Poseidon. Well, that's not true.
But like, he's not harder on himself than you are. On
no,
yourself.
No. He is. I mean, but
oh,
no,
I forgot.
Sorry,
it's not true.
I misunderstood it. Never mind.
Please don't let me be misunderstood.
Yeah, so what's not true?
No, I misunderstood it. Like, I'm not hard on myself at all. That's how I took it.
Oh, no, not at all. We said is you're...
Yeah, no,
these buildings also were made to build artillery for World War II. This very building.
Really?
Before
for real?
Sewing machines were in these buildings, they were making weapons for World War II.
Oh,
these
shit.
Buildings, yeah.
God damn.
How'd you like that Tobey Maguire shit I pulled out of my ass the other day? That was a good one.
It would have been a good one if you had more information.
Yeah.
Wait, was that real or false?
That was real.
Oh, shit, it's real. Okay, because you said pulled out of your ass.
But I saw another one. I saw another one today that was kind of cool. And I don't remember what it is, so now I feel like an asshole. But it'll come to me. It has to do with Louis Anderson. Show me! No, I'm kidding. Remember when Louis Anderson used to do that on Family Feud? Show me!
Oh, I have binge watched the best of Family Feud with what's his face there, Steve Harvey.
He's kind of funny,
bro. I don't know why it just his reaction to what people say.
You know what this guy's favorite
is? Oh my god!
He just does serious face and looks at the audience.
Yeah, but I don't know why that gets me.
It gets you all the time because you're stupid.
He's not wrong.
Fuck yourself.
He's not wrong,
but not in a bad way. No, it's because they're aiming for that, and you let them get it.
Yeah, but because it's simple.
It's just looking
it's
at the...
It's simple, yet effective.
Norman Fell used to do it on Three's Company. He would talk, say something about his wife, and then just look at the... He doesn't have to do anything. He makes the audience write the joke for them when he does that shit, when he look right?
Yeah.
It's a good move, though. He is funny, though. I'm not... I don't mean to
he
put you down about it.
You're not putting me down.
Not putting you down. The word patronize you.
Oh,
we appreciate your patronage.
Don't know what that word means.
All right, do you two buffoons have a top 10 this week?
But I'm gonna get to the top 10.
It got Charlie Rose over here.
But Steve Harvey had his fair share of struggles coming up. Struggles meaning like Cheerios.
Yeah,
like,
you know what struggles he had? How to make a bigger tie knot.
No, like
Steve Harvey's favorite thing to do is make a tie. Oh, isn't that time for
yes, top 10 top 10 list.
Our top 10
top list. 10 bullshit New Year's resolutions.
Now, why do we say bullshit resolutions? Everybody salsa.
This is a dancing gift to the ladies.
What I do is when I'm in the backseat of a car, you know the holy shit bar?
Yeah.
In the car? I would go up to the one on the right and the one on the left in the back and just do this with the music while I was in the
like
back seat while my friends were driving.
Like a monkey?
No, like just to piss them off.
Hold on. Never mind. Number 10, quit smoking.
Wait a second. Back it up.
Whoa. No, you gotta go.
Explain what this is, Poseidon. Why is it a bullshit New Year's resolution?
Because this is stuff you say you're gonna do, but you don't end up doing within the year.
Because we're all full of shit to ourselves.
Yes.
Okay. Like a couple that says, I love you, and everyone cheats.
Yeah. Or like how...
It's not cheating if you go for a happy ending massage.
Is that a rule?
That's me.
It's not cheating. I love my wife. I can't make
her... Yeah, sorry. I didn't explain the list. So yeah, that's what that is.
So quitting smoking. So, okay, let me tell you something about quitting smoking. You know those people, Pantelis, that say they're quitting smoking and just seem to never have cigarettes but always take yours?
Yeah, he's sitting right in front of you.
Oh, right.
Okay. You know what happens?
In I had a chat with him about it, and he has since bought cigarettes. So he's getting better.
Oh, yeah, it's been a while.
At not being full of shit about it.
No, look. Here's what happens. Here's the process.
Because I don't care. I never refuse cigarettes. I'll give even my last cigarette to someone. They're just open pack on the table. Here, okay. Kill yourself like
me. Let me tell you the process of quitting smoking. Okay?
Because he's an expert at it. He's an intellectual.
I've done it so many fucking times.
I just said the title of
it. But here's the process, right? So you start. You're like, that's it. I'm putting my fist down on my foot.
In my ass.
Yeah. I'm quitting smoking. That's it. Bam. You know? And I go a whole day or a whole night, and I wake up, and throughout the day, I'm good. But then something small will trigger it. I'm like, I need a fucking cigarette.
Now, Poseidon, when you decide to quit smoking, do you tell everybody about it? You hold a
first,
press conference?
No. First...
The holding accountable conference is why saying you're going to quit smoking is a bullshit.
At first, I don't. At first, I don't. But then I can't. I have to let it out. I have to.
When I quit drinking close to 3 years, nobody knew I quit drinking till like 6 months in.
Nice.
Only me. I didn't. Okay, guys, today, New Year's at midnight, my last drink. I'm not drinking. That's bullshit. I hate that shit. My brother does that shit.
Well, I could always handle my liquor, so I never had an issue.
Yeah, no, but you definitely...
But so smoking...
Would you like to quit... You know why I smoke, Poseidon?
Why?
Because I want to.
Yeah, I mean, me too. That's the issue. Is I enjoy it. I love having a cigarette with my coffee.
Because of my... my smoker's cough and my mucusy...
Oh, that's why.
Spitting, throaty...
I thought it just fell off because of the smoke.
No, because of a smoker, I had to go...
Oh, yeah, that thing. Yeah,
We're still on number 10 of this jackass idiocy.
Okay.
Number nine. Waste money at gym or lose weight.
Either or.
Yeah.
So losing weight is bad?
No, the bullshit excuse you tell yourself.
Yeah.
And the reason it's waste money at gym is so many people think somehow going to the gym but continuing with their fat fuck lifestyle will somehow change.
Let me explain to you something.
And they will... hurt themselves at the gym doing so.
Let me explain to you something. This one I'm good at.
You did lose a lot of weight in your brain.
What?
I'm
what?
Kidding.
You confused me there. This one I'm good at. So if I pay for the gym, I'll go. This I'm not so good at.
Good.
You get it?
I get it.
That's my struggle. That's my struggle.
I go to the gym, I hang out, but I'm
I'll lift weights, but
I pay my membership like a rent.
No. I'll lift weights and do the workout, but then I'll eat.
Just don't eat so much bread
like a pig.
And bread and sugar.
Bread is my issue.
Yeah.
But bread
I
has
love
sugar.
Bread too. Bread is sugar. It's a man-made substance.
So the problem with Poseidon is he can't stop putting those penis bread wrap penises in his mouth.
What are they called? Pigs in blankets.
Remember, I love those. There's nothing classier. I want to go. That's my New Year's, man. That's because I told you about the tuxedo New Year's, right? I did it yesterday.
Wait, what? Sorry, you lost me. I was thinking of something.
Okay,
hold on. I blanked out.
For New Year's, I actually put on the tux and I was in a party where I would eat pigs in a blanket like this.
Alone?
Well, no, there was others.
Look, whatever, I guess, whatever makes you happy, bro.
Quiche.
I don't know.
How about quiche? What's your favorite?
What the fuck is a quiche?
What is a quiche, bro? A quiche is a quiche, bro. You come, you fucking a picholine and a quicholine. Listen, a quiche, hors d'oeuvres. Have you ever been to a party where they have hors d'oeuvres?
Yes, they have.
What do they have?
Salmon.
Salmon how? There's a fish
swimming
up river.
With like peas and shit, whatever the fuck, bro. Bro, I don't know the ingredients. Bro, I barely know how to cook, bro.
Okay, so you're trying to say capers are peas?
Yeah.
That's what he did there?
Yep. Oh, that's what that is.
Yeah. Capers are little green flowers. Anyway, quiche is a little... what's spanakopita?
Spinach.
Okay. What's the cheese? Tiropita.
Feta.
Tiropita.
Tiropita. That one. Yeah. That's quiche. You mother. That's quiche.
Oh, what?
It's no, a mini version. It's the hors d'oeuvres.
It's disgusting compared to Ropita.
Why would they call it? Why not just call it cheese pie?
Because they didn't call it croque monsieur.
What the fuck is that?
Croque
what
monsieur. The I keep bringing that one back just for myself.
What's croque monsieur again? Where did that come
croque
from?
Croque monsieur is a sandwich that you have for breakfast in France where it's ham and cheese pressed. Ham and cheese sandwich. But it's a fancy way to...
Croque monsieur.
I got my girlfriend a panini press.
That's delicious. Fun.
I always used to put so much cheese in those.
I do that at the restaurant. I make the pizza, the sandwich with the pizza dough and I... Ooh. Motherfucker. Yeah, it's good. Eventually it'll open.
Melted. What's next on this shit show?
All right, number 8.
Go backpacking.
Like backpacking like across Europe type of shit.
Oh, but or that's like, different.
Or like in
When you
Asia.
Mentioned go backpacking before.
Oh, that's what I meant.
You told me go barebacking.
I understood that you were without protection.
I bareback all the time. They just don't know about it.
Oh, that's a horrible thing to do.
You secretly take off the condom.
Oh, that's terrible.
They think it's on. And you go, yeah, it's on. Oh, that's terrible. That's
Your girl told me to do that. That's called stealthing.
Yeah. No, it's a joke, obviously. I don't actually do that.
Stealthing is the stealth van movement where you sleep in your van in the parking lot of a Walmart. That's stealth camping.
You know, I've seen you unlock the memory. I don't know why. I went through a phase where I was obsessed with, you know, those people that turn vans into houses and
I
shit.
I love that shit. Yeah. And I've been
like,
watching them.
Like, bro, I watch this couple, bro.
Van life.
A sailboat, bro. Yeah. They live on a sailboat. They live at sea.
Well, that's the whole thing about this go backpacking. Nowadays, you have to do your
pirates used to live at sea.
Wait a second. Yeah, but with the sicknesses and the pillaging and
but
the
is it the Johnny
looting.
Depp pirate or the look at me, I'm the captain now pirate?
What?
Yeah.
Which pirate is it? Is it a Caribbean pirate or a Somali?
They did like a mini. It was a couple. They did like a mini documentary of
and
like
they
30
were
minutes. No, they weren't pirates. They even had kids and everything, and they raised the kids on the boat.
So who are the pirates?
And they
raised boat children.
Yeah, and they literally go from coast to coast.
Vikings. Hey yo. Oh. Hey.
Yeah, but that was for a few months.
So
and
these,
then
this
they
couple
left.
Was had rowers.
Oh, no. They have a sailboat.
Do they have oars?
No. Because there's an engine and
there's
a sail.
No oars.
I'm going to learn about Vikings with Assassin's Creed.
But yeah.
Okay, I understand what you're saying.
So, and they go from coast to coast. And that...
Like
and
butter
the,
and
the
toast?
Only, yeah.
Ask anybody about Freddy Bisco.
This motherfucker, how many times are you going to cut me off today, motherfucker?
That's from Scent of a Woman, by the way. When he buys the Ferrari.
They know me from coast to coast like butter and toast.
Ask anybody about Freddy Bisco.
Yeah.
Ferrari comes in here, out the door. I'm a great ghost too. Fucking Pacino. I'm so sorry I'm interrupting.
Oh, it's from a movie.
Yeah, oh my god, I'm gonna flip this table.
But van life is nice. You're right about that. And the best way to
it's not for me. I'm not saying
I
don't ever want to do that shit ever.
No, I want to do that. In New York, it's better than an apartment.
I had a phase.
You get one of those in New York and you make it look like a van with Chinese delivery spray paint.
What are you, Scooby-Doo? You're gonna go around solving mysteries? What the fuck are you talking about?
But inside it's as luxurious as a New York City
apartment.
I'm Shaggy
Scooby-Doo. You do. You are a little Scooby-Doo-esque though.
What? Yeah. We're Riley. Yeah. We're Scooby Snacks.
But that's why I'm Fat Shaggy, is because I keep eating the Scooby Snacks.
Yeah, you're Fat Shaggy. You're faggy.
Yeah, what the fuck? Oh, motherfucker. I walked right into that one. Fuck.
My favorite about Scooby Doo was the way they would eat. The way that the drawing was. Like,
right
if they
into
would
that
eat
one.
A sandwich, they would be throwing it in the air and it would go woo and land. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The drawings of the snacks, because you could just be eating like this, but they would make it throw in the air and land.
Yeah.
Open their mouth like this to put the whole thing.
No, but what I mean about
that
van
Casey
life,
Kasem.
I never had an obsession that I wanted to do it. Me, it was more of like I had an obsession. Okay, how did they transform
for
this
the
one?
Instagram to make the money?
No. How did they do this one? And then I would have to watch the whole build, how they did the build and everything. And then I would watch how they live their day to day life, like for a month.
How about How It's
like
Made? You ever watch How It's Made?
Yeah. Yes,
up? I love that. That's better.
Yeah, that was awesome.
I don't want to watch this couple make breakfast.
I went through a hydraulic press addiction. Yeah, those hydraulic press videos. Where I could just sit there on Facebook for 2 hours. Just
I used to love that how it's made. That's made here. That how it's made is made here.
Oh,
how's
really?
How's that made?
Where they show, yeah,
how hot. All right, because we went off on a
tangent. But no, it's you and the Somali pirates, bro.
Yeah, bro. I'm the captain now.
Oh boy, the list goes on.
Number seven
of the bullshit New Year's resolutions.
Fuck your wife as much as your guma. Guma is a girlfriend.
Yeah.
No. Yeah.
It's like cubaro.
Yeah, isn't it a mistress?
It's your chick on the side.
Yeah. Oh, it's a mistress. No, yeah, why is she cubaro? Cubara is the people is your brother-in-law.
No, that's in Greek though.
Your best man.
Yeah, no, kumara.
That's exactly what it means in Italian too.
Oh, really? Okay.
That's exactly what kumara. It means in this sense. It means exactly that.
Okay, okay.
And that's who you're fucking. That's where it comes from.
Because normally they fuck their
mother-in-law?
That's what it means.
Not their mother-in-law,
Do you know where carne comes from?
Your cubara, your...
you know where this comes from?
The guy that married you, his wife.
In Italian, this, you know where it comes from? That he gave the guy horns. It's not evil eye. It means the guy in town that everybody knows his wife is getting fucked except him.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what that means.
Horns. They say it in Greek too, kerato.
But that's where that comes from.
Yeah.
And that's why it comes from the
cubara. Poseidon's learning how to speak Greek because of an Italian.
It doesn't mean like evil eye. It doesn't. When you do this, it doesn't mean evil eye.
No,
it means that guy doesn't know that his wife's getting fucked.
Oh, shit.
He has a horn.
But hold on. Since this became known, wouldn't when the guy see somebody pointing at him like this?
Nobody's pointing at him. It's behind his back. That's the whole point.
It's a saying. It's like
when they're talking about him, they go, that guy there? Yeah, they're doing this.
It's the exact same.
That guy there that doesn't see us.
Also, they'll be like.
Yeah.
It's the exact same thing as in Greek. Keratonon.
Yeah.
Oh.
Keratonin, which makes your hair grow.
What?
Yeah. No, I don't know about that. But yeah, that's probably what
it means. Horns. Kerato means horns.
Yeah.
Pirato, kerato, that's not like you're saying that she's screwing someone else.
And in Jewish, it's called a shofar.
He's not going to get, he doesn't get that.
A horn.
Yeah.
It's
a shofar.
Goat horn.
No, when Larry thinks his lawyers are Jewish on the desk. What is a shofar? Why is there a shofar on your desk?
Yeah.
Oi, Larry. Oi.
You said oi.
What are you?
I haven't watched Curb.
I'm Swedish. I got a Swede as a lawyer. Oh, no. She's going to get everything.
Yeah, I remember. That was a good episode.
Am I going to see you at Temple?
No. What's next on this goofy ass list?
Number six.
Whoa. What does this say? Move to Mexico, drink from coconuts daily. Who the fuck puts that as a resolution?
Jesse the Body Ventura lives off the grid.
He does, actually.
In Mexico.
Wait,
there's
but
a reason why the governor of Minnesota loves living off the grid.
That's
people
not
have a misconception of what Mexico is versus what it really is.
But Jesse,
that's why I go live there off the grid.
But Jesse, you go off the grid, but that's not a common... resolution that you hear people say. This list doesn't make any sense.
You would never want it to drink out of a coconut.
It would have made
my
sense.
Stupid gay ass fucking Jesse impression.
Not bad.
It's not bad.
It would have made more sense if you wrote move to Mexico and
get surgery
do drugs
daily.
And fuck hookers.
Because, how would that have made more sense?
Because there was that guy. Hold on.
That's
there was
one guy. That's not a resolution.
No, but what I'm saying is,
they say you need a resolution. Yeah.
There was this guy in the newspaper. He wanted to kill himself.
We all want
and he went
save
to Mexico.
The world.
This is descended into madness.
Yeah, this is what I go through every week.
Restitution. I'm sorry. So there's a guy, El Chapo. He was Mexican. He had a mustache.
Yeah, that's what you're saying?
No, the reason I want to go to Mexico is because I don't know why. It's hot.
You know,
it's
Dumb and Dumber wasn't supposed to be a documentary, right?
No, but there really is a misconception.
Did they end up going to Mexico and Dumb and Dumber?
Yeah.
Oh, you know what I like? Remember, we forgot to talk about this the other day when we were talking about doing drugs and on New Year's and if not paying for hookers and doing drugs and then paying. In The Departed, the way Jack Nicholson snorted that coke and put it into the girl's asshole with a straw.
I haven't seen The Departed.
Well, I just explained it to you. There's a part where Jack Nicholson, you know, Jack.
Oh, like in Wolf of Wall Street.
In The Departed, when Jack Nicholson is being Jack Nicholson, and he had nothing to do with Wolf of Wall Street.
I mean like the way he did it, the same way that he did it in Wolf
DiCaprio
of Wall Street.
Did DiCaprio put it in an asshole in the movie?
No.
He did it off of a girl's asshole, I think.
No.
Or ass off cheek. Of a hooker's asshole. All ass cheek. Okay.
If I'm not mistaken, and now Jess Sorrell, correct me if I'm wrong, because she mentioned, I'm kidding. Anyway, it's just a shot. It's a perfect Scorsese shot of McDonald's arches, but it's the ass crack. And there's coke right in the middle of it, and Jack Nicholson's nose comes out of nowhere, and he doesn't offer anus.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, it's quite funny.
That sounds like a good time.
Yeah. You know who else told me that? Oh, Ricky Martin.
This motherfucker.
Yeah, whose ass did he snort it off?
I don't know, but hey, he said she was living la vida loca.
Motherfucker.
Ben Maria, te quiero.
Hey!
Ben.
Are you trying to say that Ricky Martin was snorting bits and pieces of spanakopita off his mom's ass?
I didn't say nothing.
That's fucking weird, bro.
You know what that is? That's corna. A shofar.
You should have never brought up the whole Ricky Martin thing.
But my mind was innocent when I was a child.
Brought this up as an adult.
Yeah, but hold on. Let me explain. The memory was innocent.
The memory was.
Yes.
Oh, you hadn't realized.
Yes, I hadn't realized yet.
So you
and then I said it.
The bean went over your head.
Yes, oh. And then I said it.
Wait,
for
who
the
gave
first
who head?
It's your mother.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
It's your mother.
Your mother gave him head.
What? No, bro.
Was,
shut the fuck up. Let me explain
about it.
So she had fantasies about
it. Yeah. But so did millions of other women or billions.
Yeah, no, that's fine. But because like when I said it, I didn't. Me, it was never like that. It was just she found
him.
She thought she was a handsome man.
So only recently,
until I said it, and you guys joked around.
Did
I was
you
like,
realize,
no,
because you came to a conclusion.
Because the memory was innocent.
And now it's dirtified.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you something. The memory
Those sheets
was innocent
ain't white
to you,
no more.
But the reality was dirty.
The sheets weren't white, bro. The sheets weren't white.
Your dad getting mad and her being like, get the fuck out of the house. I got to put that tape on.
That's why they were fighting.
Yeah.
That's where they're fighting. Because she was.
Oh, no.
She was fighting.
Imagine that was the cause of the divorce.
Ricky Martin.
Ricky Martin.
Under reasons and legal papers, he wrote, the gay Mexican.
And then under, they said reason, he wrote, well, she bangs.
That would have been good.
I didn't get that.
Because that's a song.
Oh.
She bangs. Oh, baby, you should move.
You know the William Hung? Like those Under Siege movies?
Do you know who William Hung is, Poseidon?
The first American Idol Asian dude that sang shit. She bangs.
You don't remember William Hung? She bangs.
He was so shit, he made millions.
Yeah, he was the worst thing ever.
He was literally.
Oh, shit.
But because he was so innocent and honest. Like Adam Crazy Adam, he was so innocent and honest that it was endearing that they gave him a record contract. But it was the work because he said, I don't know, I just tried my best.
His best was,
She bangs. It was the
best. I'm going to watch that.
No, here. Have you ever seen this, guys? Oh, this was a classic. This is a years ago. I'm going back years ago in YouTube-ness. Greek Idol Auditions.
Oh, yeah, I remember.
Have you ever seen that? It's the funniest.
Feet of the Dark.
One of the three people.
Feet of the Dark.
It's from about probably 10 years ago. I'm not kidding.
Yeah, and, it was the guy who went on singing Iron Maiden. He was the best Greekster.
The Simon
Feet
guy.
Of the Dark.
No, I'm talking even before that.
Why is he Latino?
Bro, no, he's Greek. Feet of the Dark.
Even before that.
If you guys can get through your top 10 list, I'll put it on so you can hear it. But you got to get through this.
Okay.
The Simon Cowell guy, is like, he looks like a gay hairdresser.
He is.
Okay, that guy.
Yeah,
he was
yeah.
the guy.
Yeah, yeah.
He looked like this with his plastic surgery.
Fear of the Dark.
It's
the
so
greatest
funny.
Thing.
Okay. Number five.
Number five. Get a boob job.
Okay, hold on.
You're finally going to get...
People get boob jobs all the time.
No, he's going to get them reduced.
Oh, is it all the reduction?
Maybe it's a reduction thing,
is it?
Yeah.
By the way, I told you, you don't need to get them reduced. The boobs, if you keep working out and lose weight,
yes,
they'll be fine. You, if you have excess skin, that's different.
You know what causes
the
that?
The gyms are closed.
Marijuana.
He doesn't smoke weed.
Man boobs.
But I did go through a phase from 16 to 18 where I smoked all kinds of weed.
If you have a little bit of extra shit, it might be from that.
Here's the thing. When I work out, though, most of it goes away.
Yeah.
Even though I still remain big. It just, because it tightens up, right?
Imagine if you worked out, but you ate very clean. It goes, imagine you worked out and you ate like, you ate cans of tuna and that's it.
I'd be chiseled.
Why don't you do it? Make a bullshit list.
Mercury poisoning.
Freddie Mercury? That was
Freddie
AIDS.
Mercury poisoning.
That was AIDS.
That's called...
AIDS.
That's called... Yeah. You beat me to it.
So explain the boob job thing, though.
I don't know. Just
girls
chicks
always
get them all the
time.
It was just random. It's one of those things.
I know a girl that I've been hanging out with lately that she has really wants it. And I told her they're beautiful. You don't need it. But she
I tell the same
it,
thing to women
she,
all the time.
She wants it, but then she doesn't want it. It's like
yeah,
she wants
Poseidon,
me to force her to do
it. It's weird when you say it because they didn't invite you into their house in the first place. So when you're telling them, you have nice tits, like, get the fuck out of here.
No, but like, I've met a lot of girls where they're like, I want a boob job. I'm like, Small, big, medium, whatever. Exactly. I like tits, really doesn't bother me.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But I fucked a girl in 2016 in Australia who had 2016 tits. Her fake boobs felt great.
Really?
Versus the ones in the strip clubs when we went in the late 90s and they felt like basketballs.
There was a stripper once that had fake tits and they did feel amazing.
They
also
put them under the breast plate now or something. No, breastplate, that's Pulp Fiction.
She's got breastplates. Yeah, you got to go through it.
Yeah. Just get the shot!
No, they put it under the fat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they felt, it was good.
So it just like.
And they were saline and they were great. She got them done in Thailand.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, in Mexico to Thailand. Thailand is Australia's Mexico.
Repeat that. Thailand is Australia's. Okay, yeah.
And you know what else? Baja.
That's very racist of you.
Where was that bombing in 2002?
I'm busting his balls.
Where was that bombing in 2002 in Australia that they said was their version of attacks to go into terrorism?
Bro, this is the longest fucking
list. Yeah, this is the longest top 10 list.
Can you tell I smoked weed before this?
No.
Oh, well, I did. I was actually going to take a cigarette out and light it now. I forgot where I was. I was literally about to do this.
This one goes with number 6 and 7.
Dave Chappelle says, this is called leverage. Yeah. Go ahead. Sorry, guys. I got problems.
Okay. Number 4.
Number 4.
What is that? Find yourself.
Find yourself.
Jesus Christ, bro.
You know the 3 in the morning staring at the mirror?
But who am I really?
Who am I? Sometimes staring at the mirror, though, you're doing this.
Malaka,
sometimes staring at the mirror, you're... Sometimes staring at the mirror, you're...
That's nasty.
Oh, so explain whatever happened to you with Find Yourself.
Oh, no, it was just random, bro. I'm just thinking of, like...
But you have to give an example.
I'm just thinking of... It goes with backpacking. You know what I mean?
It's like the list you make of... law of attraction and stuff like that. There's good and bad about that. Like your top 10 goals for the year, you go in there with motivation and then you just forget that you're full of shit.
No, I think it has the fact to do that you wait for the new year to finally set yourself goals. And it's a bullshit thing. Yeah. And the fact that you wait means you were never going to do it in the first place. So why
completely?
You know what I mean? Why not just set a goal for you in fucking...
Completely in denial.
July. Oh. 1998.
Bro, you know what denial is? I'll tell you what denial is. Denial is a river in Egypt.
You know, he had me going there, but now I'm angry.
Denial is a river
now
in
I'm
Egypt.
Actually angry. I hate it that you did that to me.
Bro, I'll tell you something about a girl I know. She's got a smile that it seems to me, it reminds me of childhood memories where everything was as precious as bright blue skies.
Really?
Now and then, when I see her face, it takes me away to that special place. Where if I stay too long, I'll probably break down and cry.
Oh, sweet child of mine, don't cry.
Sweet child of mine.
Poseidon, what's next on the list?
All right.
Okay, hold on.
Number 3.
Hold on. Read more books, not from self-help section, chapters, or Barnes & Noble. Okay, so read actual literature is what you're saying.
Yeah, like, you know, that Shakespeare.
Is that
Shakespeare. Is that just Britney Spears shaking it?
Pretty much, yeah.
That nice. Video, huh? How important is that video in the history of fucking shaking ass? Is that
in the
fucking,
history of mankind?
Is that Oops, I Did It Again video? I played with your heart. She's wearing the high school fucking...
I lost in the game. I'm a y'all think I'm in love.
When was it that she went crazy and shaved her head?
Years ago,
but yeah, I actually think she's got problems, that poor girl. But
they all do. They all have problems.
But she's like specific. Like her family's trying to like sign papers to not give her the rights.
Yeah,
to
they're assholes.
But oh, yeah, she might be that. Really. She might have real issues. Do you like that movie Just Friends? It's Ryan Reynolds where he goes
Sandra
back.
Sandra Bullock?
No, where he goes.
Oh, when
back
he was fat. Yeah, I've seen that. Yeah.
Okay, how good was what's her name playing Britney Spears?
I can't remember.
Come on, the comedian. She was married to Chris Pratt.
No, but I can't remember. I know who you're talking about, but I can't remember.
Bro, there's a poster of her in that movie. It's like a famous poster, like the Farrah Fawcett
poster that everyone had in their rooms. It was the girl. It was her with the bananas. She was so funny. What's her name? Come on. She has her own podcast. She was married to Chris Pratt.
I know who the girl you're talking about. She was in Scary Movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about. I just forget her name. It doesn't matter. I know who you're talking about.
Anyway, that poster is still. She's
so funny in that fucking movie.
Oh, is that the one with the black chick and the white chick?
No, that was the Wayans movies there.
Yeah, yeah.
No, it's a Scary Movie.
All right, what's the next on the list? Number two. This fucking list. Jesus Christ.
Buy a laptop.
Anna Faris.
Okay, seriously, Guido, you have to do this. You told me you're writing your scripts on a fucking typewriter.
Yeah, I like typewriters.
Would you like an abacus to go with that, you fucking dummy?
Quantum Leap. I like electric typewriters. For some reason, because of the way it feels under my
fingers. About when you travel now?
It goes, well, it's portable. It's in 1990.
Everything is portable
in 1992. It was very compact and easy to carry.
It's not 1992 anymore, buddy.
But at one point,
the World Trade Center has been bombed twice.
I buy a 93 Mercedes for $3,000, once upon a time, this car cost $100,000
and
a Space Odyssey.
In 91, I think it was bombed, the World Trade Center.
No, 93. Oh, really? It was bombed 93. In 93. 93. When on 9/11, I woke up and I heard Howard Stern, I thought it was a repeat from 93.
Hold on, 93? What date? What day?
Whenever your dad's birthday is.
Yeah.
No, was it in July?
I don't know. Is your dad's birthday in July?
No.
So then it's not.
It was not in July.
Oh.
Oklahoma City bombing. I have cousin in Oklahoma City.
Oh, okay, so buy a laptop. All right, what's next?
Number one? Last meal was... Ben and Jerry's
McVay.
Timothy McVeigh, the Oklahoma City bomber. He was
not the Unabomber.
No, the Oklahoma City bomber. Okay, his last meal was mint. Ben and Jerry's mint chip ice cream. Ted Kaczynski is still alive.
Yeah.
And
you ever read Ted Kaczynski's manifesto?
No, but also I know that a guy named Grasso was mad on his death row meal. He wanted SpaghettiOs. He ordered SpaghettiOs, and they didn't give him SpaghettiOs. They gave him Heinz. Pasta in a can, and he said, I want to make sure the press knows that I didn't get my SpaghettiOs. Those were his last words. A guy named Grasso.
That's a Grasso thing to yell about. Yeah. Would you like us to not kill you? No. The ship has sailed.
Famous last words. Check it out. Poseidon. And also, don't forget to type in Greek Idol audition.
I'm going to get it done. Don't worry. Just what's the number one?
Number one is make fuck you money in order to be able to buy a laptop.
Okay.
What would you buy with fuck you money? First thing you would do when you cash a
first
check.
Thing.
He'd fuck you.
Yeah. This is what I mean when I say
luxurious condo.
A luxurious condo meaning what? In old Montreal where you could see the
probably, yeah.
Okay. What about like a fucking house that looks like Buckingham Palace but in Saint-Sauveur?
Buckingham Palace?
Yeah, that you know who lives there?
Do you know what Buckingham Palace is?
I'll tell you who lives at Buckingham Palace. Do you know the guy who hosts La Rue de Fortune, Corbeil, where the people off door where you spin the wheel?
No.
He lives there.
At back.
The appliance specialist.
At Buckingham Palace?
Yeah, he lives there. Watch. You know the French guy?
You're Googling Buckingham Palace. How are you alive in this century? I don't understand.
Oh, is that? Oh, that's the place in the UK.
I thought it was in.
Isn't that where the Queen lives?
I love how he's saying it so matter-of-factly, moments after saying, I don't know what Buckingham Palace is.
Do you eat HP sauce?
What the fuck is HP sauce?
Horse penis.
Next to the ketchup?
What?
Next to the ketchup. You never
seen
a bottle
of HP? So what's your number one thing? Make fuck you money.
It's on Her Majesty's Secret Service. HP sauce. Did you know that it was appointed by the Queen?
I did not know
that. Hold on. What was it?
HP steak sauce.
On every bottle of HP steak sauce, it says, Queen.
All right. Look, that list sucked.
No.
Thank you for your list. We're going to now move over to lovely shit that I find online. First is...
Oh, the last part. Okay. To Her Majesty the Queen.
So Poseidon, this was... it's not a Greek Idol. It's X Factor. No,
the actual Greek Idol the specific one, though. Find that one.
This is the Greek
one.
X Factor, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. This is what I told you I was going to show you.
Oh, I see.
Asshole.
But then you got to go to the one I want to show you.
I'm a little anxious, but I'm going to use this anxiety. Once you pass your anxiety, you become number one. This is Andrea. He's the new Bruce Dickinson, he's saying.
He's singing Iron Maiden?
He goes, who's the first Dickinson? He's like Bruce.
Metal. Ποιο κομμάτι θα μας πεις τον
Μέντεν? Θα πω το Fear of the Dark, τον άλλο Μέντεν.
Fear of the Dark.
I am the man who walks alone. And when I'm walking the dark road, I know strolling through the park. When the light begins to change, I sometimes feel a little strange, a little anxious when it's dark. Fear of the dark. Fear of the dark. I have a constant fear of something always near.
He's doing Dracula.
Fear of the dark.
Fear of the dark. He's doing a monologue.
I have a phobia that someone's always there. Have you run to three days down the hall? Have you felt on the skin crow when
he's
you
doing theatrics.
Sometimes when you scare
me, I'm doing the close-up
dress. There's something watching you. Fear of the dark. Fear of the dark.
Look at his leg! Look at his leg! Look at
he has it positioned like a ballerina.
Γύρισα στο σπίτι μου, δυόμιση και κάτι, όσο κι προσπάθησα. Δεν μπορώ να κλείσω το μάτι. Μάτι πόσο υποφέρω. Που θα πάει πια δεν ξέρω. Θέλω να ξεχάσω. Μα όλο σαν αφέρω.
But they're letting him go.
Oh, they're letting him go too much, yeah.
Oh, they're Greeksters. Of course they're gonna let him go.
Oh, shit.
Look, he's making fun of him.
Μένουν άδεια. Δυόμιση και εγώ περιμένω. Τρεις κι ακόμα μόνος μου μένω.
But he's doing it confidently, I have to say.
Dude, this guy is super, super confident.
That's he's doing it confidently. That's I don't
mind
that.
The issue here is not confidence.
I don't mind that.
The issue here is that they let him go. Yeah. But another issue that we talked about is that
I like
him. Poseidon missed a huge part of growing
yeah,
up.
Yeah, you didn't know this guy? He was so cute. And it was his sincerity
that got him, right
a, he got $1 million after this.
It's kind of odd, like, why I chose to even audition in the first place. Because
this guy.
My major is civil
looks
engineering.
Looks like a cartoon.
Hold on, pause. I was about to say that. Why does he look like every cartoon
really
Asian
like
ever?
He looks like the one in Pulp Fiction.
Oh my god, look at his
he is watching.
How are you?
Hi.
Poseidon, this is going to get a little personal for you, but we're not doing it on purpose.
William.
Why?
Yes.
How are you doing today?
Oh, great. Thank
what?
You.
You're
great
doing
to
great?
You. Great to see you.
It's going
to
bring back memories.
It's actually backwards.
It's great for us to be seen by you.
It's flipped.
Yeah, it's flipped, yeah.
I like that, Paula.
William, why are you here?
I'm here to sing to America. To
what?
Sing to America. Okay, all right. I'm here for the 20
plant?
To sing to America.
No, no.
You sure?
Do you think you could be the next
American Idol?
Yeah,
absolutely.
You might be a plant.
Why?
Because I'm singing from my heart.
The other one.
I may not be the best singer around the world, but I know that I sing from my heart, and I put every bit of energy into it.
Really?
Yes.
William, what's your last name?
Hung, H-U-N-G.
Hung.
Yes.
Like a horse.
Do you have brothers and sisters?
Looking back
No, I
now.
Don't. I'm the only child.
You're the only child?
Yes.
Do your parents tell you you have a great voice?
No, they don't realize that, actually.
They don't realize it yet?
No, because when I was young, my parents
thought
that
was a retard.
I was there with them and sing with them as a hobby.
And what do they do when you sing with them?
They laugh.
What do they do when I sing with them? They thought I'm okay. They thought I have a chance of, you know, making
anyway, this
it
guy
to the next level.
Became American.
Great, are they excited
he swept
for you
America,
here?
Bro, this guy.
Actually,
well, this guy's going on and on.
He was the first viral.
I love singing.
I love
singing. Okay.
All right, let's go.
One sing. Of the first right. viral guys. Right?
Talk to me. Tell me your name. You blow me off like it's all the same. You lit it fierce and I'm ticking away like a bomb. Yeah, baby. Talk to me. Tell me your sign. You're switching sides like a Gemini. You're playing games and now you're hitting my heart like a drum. Yeah, baby. Well, if Lady Luck gets on my side, we're gonna rock this town alive. I'll let her rough me up till she knocks
me out. Is he trolling them?
She walks like she talks and
dude,
she
he could pick up your
like
mom.
She walks, she bangs, she bangs. Oh, baby, when she moves, she moves. I go crazy cause she looks like a fly, but she stings like a bee. Like every girl in history. She bangs, she bangs.
Thank
I'm
you.
Wasted by the way
Thank
she
you.
William, you did put everything you had into that.
But you, that he was so shit, he made $1 million.
Yeah, people actually, they paid him money, Poseidon.
To sing, like your REM. I actually, without making fun of him, his REM, Losing My Religion, was sellable.
You think?
That's you me in so the corner.
We got to do that again.
That's me.
We got to make you sing songs you don't know.
Yeah.
There's another, like, I don't know how much you guys enjoy the Greek ones.
I told you, but you have to find the original one. Type in American.
Oh, bro, this guy looks like a fucking
Greek
psychopath.
Idol audition.
This guy, like I swear I've never seen this before, but I just saw him in the list now and he looks like a psychopath.
Bravo.
Even the way he talks.
Greek. Okay, he's going to sing Greek. But he does seem weird. Oh, God.
What did he say?
So, well, the song they sing is very difficult.
Why is he standing like that?
What they just told him was the best.
What they told him?
Before he sings, he goes, that's not a song for you, little man. Oh, I'm going to stop one and start another. Okay, let's go. Oh my God, this is terrible.
I think it's called Super Idol Greek Funny.
Okay, I'll check it out.
Some shit like that. Dude, come on. It has that guy.
I don't think he has nipples.
Put your shirt down! Put your shirt down!
I know who he looks like.
Oh no.
Okay, I think it's called Top 10.
Hold on. Top 10?
Greek Idol Worst Auditions Top 10. Okay, it was 2007.
Okay. Oh no, English.
Greek Pop Idol Worst Auditions.
Happy birthday to you, he started singing. Did you hear that? Did you hear? Do you know anything in English? Happy birthday to you.
He looks like...
Do you know any songs in English? Happy birthday.
He looks like Mario Cantone.
Look at his reaction.
Okay. Next.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, my darling.
My darling. I like Greek Robin Williams there with.
Yeah. Holy shit, this guy's gonna pass out.
What did he say?
My friend, we don't got it.
Yeah, we don't got it.
We don't got it, bro.
Oh my God.
Happy birthday.
I found the one that you're talking about.
It's like a list. Like it's literally a list. It goes.
You know
fast.
Who he looked like? That guy, by the way, before I lose my train of thought, your friend there. Remember
Saucy.
Your friend? No.
Who?
The one that moved to the States.
Okay.
Steven Crowder?
No.
I think this might be this.
He worked at the restaurant, bro.
Staffy Psalti.
Oh, I love Staffy
Psalti. He got married to the Greek broad.
Tom Hanks.
Who moved to the States?
You drove down to for the wedding.
Milton.
Yes.
Oh, Milton.
A bit, yes.
He looked like Milton one bit. Summer. One summer, Milton did look like
that. Did
Milton
ever quit smoking?
Oh, no. Jesus Christ.
This is Marky Mark here.
Oh no. What is he doing? Look at him! He's singing a song that's meant for a woman to sing. Can I ask a question? Do you have anything else he says?
Μ' αρέσουν πάρα πολύ. Μ' αρέσει η έκρηξη, ο χορός, τα εκρηκτικά.
Τα εκρηκτικά εννοείται βόμβες.
Τώρα χόρεψα λίγο, δεν ήταν. Αυτό ήταν πολύ λίγο. Περίεργες
εποχές. Go to the next guy. Because it's like 30 minutes.
Which one do you want to show?
No.
For when your special
Holy
delivery
shit,
arrives,
it's something that Poseidon's dad would
There's so many. There's so many. They're great.
From Google.
Canadian Tire is a great store.
Yo, by the way, I know I have a relative who went on this.
I love.
Is he wearing leather pants?
Corissimo! Corissimo!
Look at her. She's trying not to laugh.
Look at Lily. He's like, yes, quite excellent. Yes, very excellent.
There's the one that the girl wanted to do Britney Spears. These guys.
Look at her, look at her, look at her, look at her, look at her trying not to laugh. Bro, these are mentally retarded.
The one where the guy is laughing.
There's no way this is real life.
Yeah, there it is. Like, there's one where the guy is laughing so much he can't stop crying. Like on Pop Idol, and it's Eye of the Tiger.
Like,
the
I don't get it.
The
like,
guy decides to sing Eye of the Tiger, and the judges were laughing so hard they were crying. It's literally Pop Idol. Guy sings Eye of the Tiger.
Like I is Greece?
In UK. Pop Idol, Eye of the Tiger. The judge is laughing so hard he's crying at the guy.
Like I enjoy singing along to songs also.
Last one.
But like I have. Like, I knew from a young age I was never going to be a singer.
You know what? I think Anthony said it that night when Mike and when they were we were all doing...
Like that
he
night...
Said it's a matter of confidence, but to actually know... you can mimic or... You know what I mean? But, it's a bit of all of it.
But, like I knew I wasn't going to sing well when that night. When
but
I
you
karaoke.
Went all in on being shit.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, fuck it. I was like, yo, I'm just going to...
You
I'm
went
having
all
fun,
in on
bro.
Being shit.
Yeah,
I
knew.
Sat
I
with
knew,
my
yeah,
eyes
yeah.
closed trying to be serious.
I wasn't...
Gay.
What?
It was terrible. But you can also find songs that you could talk. There's songs that are talkable and not like, you're not going to reach, I'm not going to reach Journey, don't stop, believe, it's not going to happen.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
You want to talk a song, you know, or do a,
I always wish
Eminem
I could sing
song.
Like The Weeknd.
What yeah. do you mean?
Like the way he sings.
Everybody's working for the weekend.
Well, nobody can sing like
you
that,
you take
right?
a piece of
like
my
that's,
heart.
That's crazy.
You better start from the start.
No, I don't mean the. I mean the.
What's a song?
R&B like artist, The Weeknd.
So give me an example.
Fuck, I don't know. I can't think one off the top of my head now. I don't know. Rolling Stone.
Papa was a Rolling Stone.
No, actually, it doesn't sing it like that.
No. So that's because that's
The Birds, Valerie, Montreal. Valerie.
You're just naming titles.
The yeah. Birds and everything turn.
Are you putting the
there
other?
Is a season.
I'm trying to
the
find
Eye
one.
The Tiger.
Turn.
Oh, the Eye of the Tiger. We'll have to look for.
What did you say?
It's Pop Idol audition. Worst Pop Idol auditions. Eye of the Tiger.
Pop Idol. Eye of the Tiger audition.
Because American Idol was Pop Idol in Britain. Simon Cowell. Simon.
Hello, love. Oh, I found it.
This guy, so the judge is laughing so hard he's crying
oh
at this poor bastard.
I love that Simon Cowell does it, all of them. Well, it's his show, right?
Yeah, that's why. But this guy's so bad that it's... I,
a maths degree, okay? Do you honestly believe that you are the next pop idol?
Do you honestly believe?
I think only time will tell.
I think only time will tell you if you're the best next pop idol.
Rising up, back on the streets, did my time, took my chances. Went the distance, now I'm back on my feet. Just a man and his will to survive. It's the eye of a tiger, it's the thrill of the fight. Rising
the of the fright.
To the challenge of our rival. And the last known survivor stalks his prey in the night as he watches us the fall in the eye of the tiger.
Oh wow. Foxy. That hurts.
His laugh is making me laugh.
War, that was great. Oh mate, that was
not the reaction I expected.
Not the reaction I expected.
That was great.
Well, you sound a bit like this, mate.
Oh wow.
Oh poor guy, bro. Oh shit.
Oh, that was great.
Oh, you can literally see his dreams leave his eyes. Shatter in his eyes. You can oh poor guy.
Like a trapeze artist that misses. You know, at the Olympics.
But at least
he shattered his dreams. But talk about not a good sense of self.
I felt
really
for him.
Are you the next pop idol? I think only time would tell.
I think that audition
tells everything. But
let's make you sing a song, bro.
Fuck, man. I don't think we could on the podcast.
No, you could sing.
Could we put just the instrumentals?
Well, I could
sing an instrumental song.
Yeah, sing an instrumental.
Sing an instrumental song.
Oh, but I'm terrible musically. I don't have it. I don't think
it's humanly possible. Well, you could say if you're a beatbox. Have you ever seen that?
The only beatbox I know how to do is boom. Guy from France.
The beatbox guy from France that was on one of these shows.
Speaking of beatbox, do you guys remember the whole beatbox craze? Do you remember the whole beatbox craze?
The nightclubs, man. France, France Idol beatbox. He's like a fat guy.
No, I don't care about him. But what were you going to say, Poseidon?
But do you remember the whole craze about the beatboxing?
Well,
like how?
Beatboxing?
How weird was that little?
Your parents did.
Wasn't weird, yeah. I mean,
there was like a phase where it was like the shit. Like, remember parkour? There was a phase where parkour
yeah, you're right.
was the shiznit. But parkour, I guess.
What's the shiznit now?
But parkour, yeah. Parkour is cool, bro.
I like when you do it not off a building. I like when you do parkour not off the ground.
I like it when it becomes an obstacle.
Yeah, like in obstacle. Between bars at the Olympics.
Yeah,
I like
but
it
not
that
just
way.
That. You make it like
skateboarding shit.
But you make like a trajectory.
Ooh, he used the word trajectory.
You know what I mean?
Is that what you use on a farm to harvest?
What?
The big machine that you go on a farm to harvest?
That's a harvester.
That's a harvester?
Of sorrow.
It's not a trajectory.
Harvester of sorrow. I thought
it harvester was of tears.
I thought it was a trajectory. Get on the trajectory. We're gonna go pick some we're gonna go fight some vermin.
You know, but like beatboxing, I never understood the craze about that.
It's because everything's done from the mouth on a mic. It's like the guy from Police Academy that makes all the funny sounds. You remember him?
It's like fucking. Black guy. It's like Cardi B Star Wars sounds. Have you seen that? Guido, have you seen Cardi B Star Wars sounds? It sounds like you're sucking cock.
That's the sound that came out of your mother's bedroom.
All right, Guido.
You're overdoing it.
Have you ever seen...
you're overdoing it and you're going to get backhanded.
Oh, I like that you're fighting back about that. No one talks about my mother like that. You're right. Have you ever seen the video? I'm not trying to always plug videos, but you know who Peter Cullen is?
No.
Peter Cullen is the voice of Optimus Prime, and he's from Montreal. You know Optimus Prime, Transformers? When they made the Transformers movie, they made sure to bring back the same voice as Optimus Prime because it was so iconic. So he's a big voiceover actor.
Okay.
And he is also the guy who invented the sounds Predator makes.
What was that sound that Predator makes?
It's like all shit like
that's
that.
That's not that sound.
It's like whatever.
That.
It's a weird sound.
Isn't it like a clicking sound? Like a
yeah, it's a click. Exactly. Like so they asked him about the audition. How did he go? How did he... So they brought him to the audition and they said, okay, can I have the science? Can I have the papers? Because it was so secret, you know, they didn't. So they gave him a little bit, what would an alien sound like? He's like, I don't know. I don't. And he just decided to go with it. Something out of this world, they said.
You're talking about Optimus?
Peter Cullen, when he did the Predator, how did he come up with it? He said, do me a favor. Sound engineer in the back, I want you to blast your volume all the way up. And I want everybody to be quiet. I want you to not make a sound. And he just made those little...
Stop doing it. It's disgusting.
I know, yeah. But nobody ever did that, is what I'm saying. Is that everyone else was doing alien sounds, and he went in the audition doing something completely different and just turning up the mic so crazy and doing the sensitivity of that you can't emulate it, but that sound, that term, that Predator sound, he's done ever since.
Oh, yeah, clicking. I was right.
That's what he did. That's what he did.
No.
Yeah. Whatever the hell...
Oh my God! How do you do that? That's so weird.
That's a guy doing that with his tongue, and that's the Optimus Prime guy.
Oh, what the fuck, bro?
Yeah,
that's wild.
Peter Cullen.
I can't even begin to picture.
Yeah.
God damn. Yeah, that's a little intense.
But it's cool. It's a whole. You know, it's a whole. You know who's big in that world? Apparently, when you meet him in real life, if you meet Mark Hamill at a party and you say, "Star Wars changed my life." He's going to be like, okay, cool, and give you the cold shoulder.
Ooh.
But if you talk to Mark Hamill about his voiceover work, he'll talk for hours about that.
Like about playing the Joker and
about,
stuff?
Yeah, because he did the best Joker of all of them, and he did a lot of commercials. He loves voiceover, Mark Hamill.
Mark Hamill is
Star Wars.
Luke.
Luke. If you talk to him about Star Wars, he's going to be like, yeah. But if you talk to him about voiceover, he'll talk for hours.
I get really? Him. I love voiceover, too.
Yeah, I love that shit, too. Interesting. That's why I know this story.
You know, there was a, I think, I don't remember in which movie, which Star Wars it was, but there was a continuation problem with the movie because he had gone into a car accident and he was
continuity.
Left scarred.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, there was a continuity issue with the movie. I think it was in the second one. There was episode 4, 5, 6. One, yeah. I don't remember which one it was.
Mark Hamill's face.
Yeah, like there was a scar or some type of shit and it was difficult to hide. I don't know.
Apparently David Lynch was given the script of Star Wars.
Whom's?
David Lynch.
Was supposed to direct it?
Landau and Anthony were talking about this. David Lynch had a meeting. There's an interview with David Lynch about how his meeting with George Lucas went. And David Lynch is notoriously very honest in how he feels, how he talks about his experiences. And he said, I don't know, I went to this this restaurant with George Lucas telling me about aliens and I got to do that. I didn't want to do it. It was just kind of funny. I'm not doing it justice, but... David Lynch is a hell of a director. You want to see some fucked up movies, man?
David Lynch? Like, fucked up, like how? Like, scary horror movies?
Was it Lost Highway, where they're fucking and driving? Or was that other one that came out? Mulholland Drive is another one. Blue Velvet. David Lynch is a good... he's out there.
He's out there.
Crash. I think it's Crash.
David Lynch.
Like this episode crashed and burned hard.
Like I was stopping. That was retarded.
Don't be self-conscious. We have a list here about things you gotta do. You gotta better yourself, bro.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining this episode of The Intellectuals. I've been your host, Poseidon, and this has been my co-host, Guido Grasso. Don't forget, Two Drink Minimum goes live on Monday nights. What?
Are you giving that back to Adam Sandler?
Yeah.
How? Give you a bracelet. Give you a bracelet.
Don't forget, where was I going with this? Kumara.
You're gonna fuck.
Oh, yes. The Poseidon69 for me on Instagram and Twitter. And Guido, where do we find you?
Right here.
Peace.